Hello all, my name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I'm a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I'm creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos.
Anyways, today in this particular lecture, we're going to discuss about the channel capacity of a discrete memoryless channel. So these are the outlines. We're going to start up with the introduction, where we're going to discuss whatever we have learned in our earlier lecture. Then we're going to discuss about your discrete communication channels, what are they and how we're going to represent them. Then we're going to discuss the channel capacity of discrete memoryless channel. And finally, we're going to conclude by discussing channel capacity of your binary symmetric channel. So in our last lecture, we have discussed about the binary symmetric channel and its representation through the transition matrices, where we have discussed that in your binary symmetric channel, the error probabilities, that is when we're going to transmit 0 and receiving 1, or when we are transmitting 1 and receiving 0, both are same. That is why the term symmetric comes into picture. Then we have discussed about the mutual information and its physical significance. What it basically mutual information is, it basically the information transferred from your source to the destination, and we really wanted that it should be as maximum as possible. So we have also studied about the various types of channel, such as your noiseless channel, your distortionless channel, etc. And now we're going to discuss about the capacity of your discrete memoryless channel. So discrete memoryless channel or discrete communication channels, as we discussed that in order to connect your transmitter as well as your receiver, we will be having some physical medium, that is your channel. And that communication channel would have been characterized with the help of your transition matrices. So a discrete channel is characterized by the input alphabet X and output alphabet Y, and the set of conditional probabilities, probability of IJ will be equal to probability of YJ given XI, that is probability of receiving YJ symbol when XI symbol would have been transmitted and it is known to us. So here again, your X and Y are your two random variables, which will basically going to model the source or the symbol received or transmitted by your sources. So this particular figure is basically showing the schematic view, that is at your source side we'll be having a source generator which will going to generate different symbols such as your x0, x1, x2 up to x of I minus 1, and at the receiving side, which would have been represented by this random variable y, we'll going to obtain yj number of symbols, that is your y0, y1, y2 up to your y of j minus 1. So this is the schematic of your discrete communication channel. We assume that the channel is memoryless, that is the occurrence of one symbol will not going to affect anyhow the occurrence of another symbol. That is for a binary channel in which we will going to only generate two symbols, or which is only capable of generate two symbols, your joint probability y1 y2 given x1 x2 will be equal to the multiplication of individual probabilities, that is probability of 1 1 1 2 2 1 and 2 2. Here this your 1 1 is basically representing your probability of receiving one when first symbol was transmitted. This is your probability of receiving first symbol when second symbol was transmitted. This is associated the probability of your second symbol when first symbol was transmitted, and this is associated with the probability of reception of second symbol when second symbol was have been transmitted. So in order to calculate the channel capacity of a discrete memoryless source, we will need to consider the number of entropies. So first of all, we need to consider this entropy h of x, which would have been given as your minus summation over I p of xi log base 2 p of xi, where p of xi is basically representing the probability of occurrence of symbol xi, and your source is capable of generating I number of symbols. So the input entropy, which measures the average information content of the input alphabet, would have been given as your h of x. The basic definition is your minus pi log of pi. So this is the entropy associated with your average information content of your source x. The output entropy, which measures the average information content of your output alphabet, and that would have been given as your, since we are observing y as a symbols, so h of y will be equal to minus summation of I, that is the whole number of symbols that your receiver will going to obtain. So we will going to take the summation of all those number of symbols, p of yi log base 2 p of yi, where p of yi is basically representing the probability associated of the reception of ith symbol. So now next entropy that we need to consider is your joint entropy, which measures the average information content of a pair of input and output symbols. Here we are specifically talking about your source, receiver as well as channel. We will going to see the combined impact. Or equivalently, the average uncertainty of the communication channel formed by the input alphabet, channel, and the output alphabet as a whole. This is what I wanted to mention at this particular point. So that joint probability or your joint average information that will be given as your h of x comma y, that will be equal to minus double summation of first summation over I and second summation over j. So total summation of probability of joint probability of xi comma yj log base to joint probability of xi comma yj. So this is how we will going to evaluate the joint probability, which measures the average information content in the pair of input output samples. So the next entropy that we need to consider is your conditional entropy, that is h of y given x, that is uncertainty associated in observing y when it is given that x symbol would have been transmitted, which measures the average information quantity needed to specify the output symbol when the input symbol is known. This is the physical significance of this hy of x, what is basically it is representing, that would have been given as your h of y given x will be equal to again minus times of double summation over I as well as j, joint probability of xi comma yj log base to probability of yj given that xi symbol would have been transmitted. So this is how we will going to calculate the conditional entropy. So here one thing should be noted, that the conditional entropy or uncertainty about the receiving symbol yj when xi symbol was transmitted, it needs to be averaged all over your xi's as well as your yi's in order to calculate the overall uncertainty. So that is why we have used this double summation. Now the conditional entropy h of x given y, that is the entropy or average information content in x when it is known that y symbol would have been received, which measures the average information quantity needed to specify the input symbol when the output or received symbol is known to us, that would have been given as your h of x given y, that is again equal to negative double summation of over I over j, where this I and j are representing your input symbols as well as your output observed symbols. That will be the joint probability of xi comma yj log base to probability of xj given yi. So here this h of x given y is the average amount of information that would have been lost in the channel, and it is called equivocation. So obviously we must have to reduce out this lost information so that we will going to get the better signal reception at our receiving side. So the following relationships between the entropies hold, that we had already discussed when we were discussing about your mutual information, which is the measure of amount of information transferred from your source to the destination. So h of x comma y will be equal to h of y comma x, that is your joint average information will be given as your h of x plus h of y given x, that will also equal to h of y plus h of x given y. So the information flow through the mutual information or the channel would have been defined by I of x semicolon y, that will be equivalent to your h of x minus h of x given y. This we had already discussed when we were discussing about your mutual information. In case of any doubt, you can refer to our last video lecture where we have also discussed the physical significance of your mutual information. So therefore we can write as mutual information x semicolon y will be equal to h of y minus h of y given x, and instead of this h of y given x, we have used the relationship, that is h of y given x will be equal to h of xy minus h of y. So via putting this particular relationship from this particular equation, what we are going to obtain is the mutual information between x and y will be equal to h of x plus h of y minus h of xy, means the complete average information in your source x plus the complete average information in your y minus the overall average information in both, that is your x and y. So the capacity of the channel would have been defined as your maximum of px. Here this maximum of px is quite important, that is whatever we wanted is we want that from source maximum amount of information would have been transferred to your receiver. So that will be equal to I of x semicolon y. Please keep in mind here your unit is bits per symbol. That is, it is basically going to give us the information, the capacity of average bits transmitted, or the information in terms of bits per symbol that would have been transmitted from source to the destination. If we really wanted to observe the actual channel capacity, then we have to multiply this bits per symbol capacity with your symbol rate, and we will going to obtain the actual bit rate or bits per second that would have been given as your Again, same, we have to maximize this P of X, I of X semicolon Y multiplied with your RS. Here, RS is basically representing your number of symbols per second. When we're going to multiply with this capacity with the bits per symbol, we will going to obtain this number of bits per second, or you could say your bit rate. So now, making use of this particular relationship, where the marginal probability of P of XI would have been given as your summation over J, the joint probability of XI comma YJ. Obviously, if joint probability would have been given to us and we have to obtain the marginal probability, then we have to sum them over the J number of symbols. So here H of X will be equal to minus summation over I P of XI log base 2 PI. This is the basic definition of your average information of your source. That will be equal to, obviously, after putting this particular relationship, what we're going to obtain is double summation. First is your over I and second is your over J. The joint probability of XI comma YJ log base 2 P of XI. So here we have replaced this probability of XI with this summation over J joint probability of XI comma YJ. So now combining with this expression of H of X given Y, it will going to give us your information that would have been transported from source to destination, that will be equivalent to your H of X minus H of X given Y. This is the basic definition of your information. That will be equal to double summation of joint probability of XI comma YJ log base 2 probability of XI given YJ divided by probability of XI. So we just have used this particular expression and this relationship in order to obtain the information transfer from source to the destination. So now we will going to focus over your binary symmetric channel. So the earlier discussion that would have been discussed is equally applicable to all the discrete memoryless sources. But here we will going to only focus about your binary symmetric channel. So in the case of binary symmetric channel, information that would have been transferred from source to destination is maximized when H of X is maximized. And when H of X would have been maximized, or entropy would have been maximized, when the occurrence of both these two symbols will be equal to same, that will be equal to 1 by 2. So in that particular case, your capacity would have been given as your information transfer from X to Y or source to destination, where we'll be having this probability of X naught will be equal to probability of X1, that is equal to 1 upon 2. So the capacity that we have obtained in our last expression, when we're going to put these probability values, that is equal to half, we will going to obtain the channel capacity of your binary symmetric channel. So for a binary symmetric channel, what is peculiar about is the error occurrence probability, that is when we're going to receive y naught symbol when x1 symbol was transmitted, that will be equal to of receiving your y1 symbol when x naught symbol would have been transmitted, that is equal to p. So here that error probability will be equal to p. And what about your detecting your correct symbol transmission, that is probability of y naught when x naught would have been transmitted, that will be equal to probability of receiving y1 when x1 would have been transmitted, that will be equal to 1 minus p. So the direct substitution of the above transition probabilities into the last expression for I of X semicolon Y and making use of Bayes' theorem, that is probability of XI comma YJ will be equal to, this is the direct substitution of your Bayes' theorem, that will be equal to probability of YJ given XI multiplied with probability of XI. And it will also be equal to probability of XI given YJ multiplied with your marginal probability of YJ. So which will going to give us C is equal to 1 plus P log base 2P plus 1 minus p log base 2 1 minus p. When we will going to put above these two relationships in our last equation, we will going to get the final expression of your channel capacity. Here also one should keep in mind that this is your channel capacity per symbol basis, that is how many number of bits per symbol we will going to transmit from source to the destination, or basically we are in a state to transmit from source to the destination. So now this particular figure is basically showing your variation of channel capacity with your transition probability. So we can clearly observe that as the transition probability or your error probability will keep increasing on, your capacity will going to get decreased. And when transition probability P is equal to 0, in that particular case, your channel capacity will be maximum, which would have been represented by this particular point. And when transition probability equal to 0.5, then your channel capacity will get reduced to 0. So we can now see the binary symmetric channel capacity varies as a function of the error or transition probability. So when the error probability is 0, we have the maximum channel capacity, which would have been given by this particular point, which is equal to the binary symmetric source information content. When the error probability is 0.5, that is equal to half, then we are receiving totally random symbols and all the information is lost in the channel, which is the case, which is the total case of your equivocation. So, which is completely undesired. So, hopefully you guys have got the insight about the channel capacity of your discrete memoryless channel as well as your binary symmetric channel. In case of any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I'll try to solve them out as soon as possible. These are the references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.